But boric acid, I was just saying, is toxic. So whenever you all are playing carom, make sure that after you play, please wash your hands very well, very carefully. It's a toxic substance. Okay, it can cause vomiting and other things if you ingest it.
I do everything what you told.
Great. Okay, so now besides being sour in taste, all of us so far we were saying that acids are sour in taste and whatever is sour has to be an acid. But there is another peculiarity, and that is that they cause irritation and a stinging sensation. Remember Hansita said all these acids give us a burning sensation when you touch an acid. So it's not just touching, but if the acid goes inside your living skin, your outer skin is dead skin, but inside, if it goes inside where your skin cells are living and inside your blood, these acids can cause an irritation and a stinging and a burning sensation. So remember the time an ant bit you or a bee stung you? It itched and irritated very bad. That's because of the formic acid, as somebody had earlier mentioned, you know? Formic acid, yes. Acid. Bee stings, ant bites, all these contain formic acid. And when this acid gets into your blood, it causes that itch and irritation. But it's not just this formic acid. If you remember and you've ever eaten suran, elephant's foot yam, this thing down below. Or if you've eaten foods made out of colocasia leaves. Everyone knows both these substances, I mean both these vegetables, elephant's foot yam, suran, and colocasia leaves, aluchi pana, alu vadi khali na hai.
Yes, I didn't understand this.
Okay. Sushant, tu pa alu vadi khali na hai ka, suran khali na hai ka? Ansita and Banu Prakash, I don't know what these foods are called locally in your area, but I'm sure these are very common vegetables used all over India. Okay, this elephant's foot yam, suran, grows like a round thing and it's huge. That's why it's called the elephant's foot yam. It looks as big as an elephant's foot kind of a thing. And these colocasia leaves also are grown, they specifically grow a lot in monsoon, in rainy season, and people cook them. Okay, but if you've ever eaten something from these vegetables which has not been cooked properly, then you'll get an irritation in their throat. Correct? Anyone's experienced that irritation where a piece of uncooked suran or not properly cooked suran or a not properly cooked colocasia leaf? Oh, all of you are so lucky, you all have not experienced this irritation. Apan Marathi madhe, those who don't understand Marathi, Marathi madhe manto na ki khas yete hai. Ye sagre yanna khas aste ya foods la. Okay, and that khas needs to be removed. That's that irritation. Okay, so because you all are such lucky, fortunate souls, I will request you to be unlucky a little bit. Next time when your mom makes suran or makes this patra ka paan or alu vadi, ask her to give you a small bit and just put it on your tongue, okay? Especially on the side of your tongue, on the back of your tongue. Put it and you'll get that very funny irritation feel. Don't miss it. It's like an experience